Subscribe to Simplified Biology channel and press the bell icon to get notified when a new video is uploaded. Hello friends, welcome to Simplified Biology. Today's topic is Phylum Platyhelminthes. Phylum Platyhelminthes. The examples are Tinea, that is tapeworm, Planaria, and Fasciola, that is liver fluke. And the trick to remember them are Tino ki planning fail hui. Tino is for Tinea, planning is for Planaria, and fail is for Fasciola. Characteristics of phylum Platyhelminthes. They have a dorsiventrally flat body. Means the dorsal surface and the ventral surface can be differentiated. And that is why they are referred as flatworms. They are either free living. The free living ones are aquatic or parasitic. They are mostly parasites and they are endoparasites, living in animals, including human beings. The body shows bilateral symmetry, means they can be divided into two equal halves at one plane passing through the center. They have a triploblastic body, means it can be divided into three layers, ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. The body wall can be divided into three layers, ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. They are acoelomate, means they have no body cavity. A loose tissue called parenchyma is found present. They have an organ level of organization, means the tissues group together to form the organs. Digestive system is incomplete as they absorb nutrient directly from the body surface of the host organism. They respire to the body surface. The nervous system is ladder-like. It has a brain ganglion and a pair of ventral nerve cords. This is the brain ganglion present in the head region. And these are the two ventral nerve cords arranged in the form of a ladder. No locomotory organs are present. The parasitic forms have suckers and hooks that act as organ of attachment by which they get attached to the host organism. Specialized cells called the flame cells are present, which carry out the function of excretion, and they are also osmoregulatory. They also carry out osmoregulation. These are bisexual organisms, means both the sexes are present in the same organism. Fertilization is internal. And the development is indirect as it has many larval stages. They are capable of regeneration. Planaria has a high regeneration capacity. Now, if a planaria is cut into pieces, each piece has the capability to develop into a new individual. So these are the characteristics of phylum Platyhelminthes. That's all for today. Please do like, subscribe and comment, and also visit our website by clicking on the link given below. Thank you. Thank you for watching.